Lutheran Church. Welcome to our Friday doctrine class. And once again, I thank you for staying in our doctrine class. And I could sense that most of you are still eager, still anxious, and still passionate in hearing the words of God. Amen. We're still in our series in the book of Acts. In the title is The Church Alive, and we are now in our lesson number 7. And the title for our lesson for this afternoon is "And They Continued." It's in the book of Acts in chapter 2 in verses 42 to 47. I will request you to open your Bible and open in the book of Acts in chapter 2 in verses 42 up to 47. And I will request you to please stand for and reverence the word of God. I will read the verses and kindly follow after me with your eyes only. Amen.
Amen.
In the book of Acts in chapter 2 verses 42 to 47, chapter 42, "And they continued steadfastly in the apostles' doctrine and fellowship, and in breaking of bread, and in prayers. And fear came upon every soul, and many wonders and signs were done by the apostles. And all that believed were together, and had all things common, and sold their possessions and goods, and parted them to all men, as every man had need. And they, continuing daily with one accord in the temple, and breaking bread from house to house, did eat their meat with gladness and singleness of heart, praising God, and having favor with all the people. And the Lord added to the church daily such as should be saved." Again, "And the Lord added to the church daily such as should be saved." Let's pray. Oh dear God in heaven, we thank the Lord for this opportunity that you gave us, especially, oh God, for your servant. And I ask the Lord to empower me, Lord, with your Holy Spirit, and embolden me, oh God, with your words. And also, Lord, I pray that you're going to bless the hearers of your words, my brothers and sisters here, oh God, that you are going to instill them the words in their lives so they may continue to be a true disciple of yours in your kingdom. We thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated now. I think some of you have a personal experience in your life, in your Christian life, when you have invited a friend of yours or a colleague of yours, and you have invited them to this church, and even you were excited to see them acknowledging the invitation of the pastor and coming to the front to receive the Lord Jesus Christ in your life and professing that they accept it in their lives. And you were also eager to see them coming in this church every Friday or every Sunday in the Vesper service. But then, months and months had come, passed by, you noticed that you could not see their presence anymore in the church. You haven't been seeing them now back. You haven't been seeing them in the church again for quite some time. And you'll be wondering why. Why is this that they did not continue with their spiritual life, or even in further hearing the word of God? In John chapter 8, verse 31, I will read this one. "Then said Jesus to those Jews which believe on him, If ye continue in my word, then are ye my disciples indeed." If ye continue in my word, then are ye my disciples indeed. So really you can differentiate a true disciple and a fake disciple. You can differentiate a true worshiper and a fake worshiper. Or you can differentiate the sheep from the goat. Because those who continue in the words of God are the true disciples of Christ. Amen? Amen. So in this book of Acts, we can see that this is an organized church, a very empowered church. They displayed the genuineness of their faith by continuing. I think we should do it like this way. We should continue on with our faith, continue in hearing the words of God, and especially those who have the ministry, you should continue on your ministry. Continue sharing the words of God. Continue on serving the Lord. Continue on helping the church by their finances, in tithes and giving. And that's the mark of a true disciple for our Lord Jesus Christ. Because one of the characteristics of a true disciple is that they continue. They continue. They don't stop. They continue in sharing the word of God. They continue with the service to the Lord. And being a true disciple, next, please. And being a true disciple, you need to continue on the following. We have three points. The doctrine, we should continue on our doctrine, should be our priority. The doctrine should be our priority. It's in verse 42 to 43, next. We should continue with our devotion, which is very widespread for all of us. We should continue with our devotion. And number three, we should continue on our dedication, which was persistent. So these are the three items that a true disciple should continue on being a Christian. The doctrine, devotion, and dedication. Now we'll go to number one. Doctrine should be a priority in our life. Actually, doctrine is simply a set of teachings or beliefs. We have several doctrines in BBC, and I know you know some of them. And I think one of the most important doctrine we have is the doctrine of salvation.
Amen.
The doctrine of salvation. The members of the early church in Jerusalem were all possessors, not merely professors of salvation. I hope most of us are possessors of salvation.
Amen.
Because I know some that they didn't continue with their spiritual life because they only profess. They just openly declare, but then in their heart, it doesn't exist. We should be a possessor of salvation. In 1 John verse 2, 19, 1 John chapter 2, verse 19, they went out from us, but they were not of us. For if they had been of us, they would no doubt have continued with us. But they went out that they might be made manifest that they were not all of us. So I think for the past years, I think here in BBC, I think you could note some of us, some of our brothers who had left the church. And it simply means one thing. It simply means one thing, that they were not of us. These people went out from the church because they made a profession of faith rather than truly accepting Christ as Savior of their lives.
Amen.
They went out of the church because they made only a profession of faith rather than truly accepting Christ as their Savior and the Lord of their life. By the way, what is our doctrine of salvation, by the way? What is our doctrine of salvation? It's simply in Romans 10:9. In Romans chapter 10, verse 9. What is it? What is it now? Romans 10:9. That if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thine heart that God had raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved.
Amen.
Because we know that salvation comes only by grace through faith in our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. And secondly, our doctrine tells us that if you are saved, you will in no way be cast out in His kingdom. Amen. In John chapter 6 verse 37. In John chapter 6 verse 37. I will read. All that the Father giveth me shall come to me, and him that cometh to me I will in no wise cast out. So if you are saved, you are really saved. Amen?
Amen.
So that's the first one. We should embrace our doctrine of salvation.
Amen.
Amen. Number two, we should hold on to the doctrine of the apostles. We should hold on with the doctrine of the apostles. That is the word of God. In 1 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 13, for this cause also thank we God without ceasing, because when ye received the word of God which ye heard of us, ye received it not as the word of man, but as it is in truth, the word of God, which effectually worketh also in you that believe. So, for us as Christians, we should continue on holding on with the doctrines of the apostles, that is the word of God. Amen?
Amen?
We should give attention to the doctrines of the word of God. We should give attention to the doctrines of the word of God. In 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 13, till I come, give attendance to reading, to exhortation, to doctrine. It's in 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 13. So if you are here for the doctrine, verily you will continue with your life being a Christian. Nothing is as important as the teaching of the word of God.
Amen.
Always in our Friday main service, our pastor is always telling us the word of God is very important. It's a part of the service. Amen?
Amen.
Why should we continue on with the words of God? Probably others would say, kung hirap na being isang Kristiyano, you should learn and learn and learn with these words of God in the Bible. There's so many things to learn, and you should continue on learning. Why? Why we should need to learn more on the words of God, anyway? Why? Because our adversary, the devil, is cunning. Ang atong kalaban, suitik, utusok. So we should be more wise than him, than the devil.
Amen.
That is by continuing learning and learning with the words of God.
Amen?
Amen. Because in Proverbs chapter 1 verse 5, in Proverbs chapter 1 verse 5, a wise man will hear and will increase learning, and a man of understanding shall attain unto wise counsel. Again, a wise man will hear and will increase learning, and a man of understanding shall attain unto wise counsel. And secondly, because the scripture is an inspiration given by God. In 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16, all scripture is given by inspiration of God. So as Christians, we should continue on learning and learning with the words of God. There are many instances in the church that you can learn this. You can attend the Bible study during Tuesday in Gupta. We also have a Bible school in the afternoon during Friday from 4, am I right? 4 to 6. And Vesper service on Sundays. We have a lot of activities in the church to keep you on learning with the Word of God. And even you can also attend the Bible studies in several groups for you to learn more in the Word of God. Amen? Second, Roman numeral 2. Devotion was prevalent. That is in verse 44. Devotion was prevalent. That is widespread. Devotion was widespread. And all that believed were together and had all things common. This is in verse 44. Please take note that the early church was filled with loving people. The early church during that time was filled with loving people. I'm sure here in BBC, I think most of us are loving people. Amen? Amen? Continuing discipleship is always based on love for the Savior and love for one another. Again, I will repeat this. Continuing discipleship is always based on love for the Savior and love for one another. Devotion. The first, devotion in fellowship. Devotion in fellowship. It is our spiritual duty as believers to stimulate one another to holiness. That is by fellowship. By fellowship. The Greek word for fellowship, koinonia. Koinonia means partnership or sharing. It means partnership or sharing. It is very important for us as Christians, once you are a member of the church, you should have a fellowship. You should fellowship with each other. You should fellowship with your brothers and sisters. Every obedient Christian should be an active participant in the local church. Amen? Every obedient Christian should be an active participant in the local church. Not just by sitting down on the chair and just warming your chair there, but you should be actively involved in the several activities of the church. We have a lot of activities here, and I think each one of you have a part in the body of the church. Amen? Amen. In Romans chapter 15, verses 5 to 6, now the God of patience and consolation grant you to be like-minded, if not like-minded, one toward another, according to Christ Jesus, that ye may with one mind and one mouth glorify God, even the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. So fellowship with other believers is extremely important to us. That's what changes an assembly or a congregation into a church. Fellowship changes an assembly or a congregation into a church. Being an active member, you should have fellowship with each other. You You will have your brother or sister carry the burdens you have. You will have your brother or sister share the joys if God has blessed you. That's fellowship. That's fellowship. So it's very important for us as Christians to be an active participant in the church. Have fellowship with our brothers and sisters. Amen?
Amen.
Now, next, there will be. There will be devotion in breaking bread. That is the communion. The devotion in breaking bread. That is in our communion. What communion? One, devotion in fellowship. Second one, the devotion in breaking bread. In 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 16, I will read this. The cup of blessing which we bless, is it not the communion of the blood of Christ? The bread which we break, is it not the communion of the body of Christ? Communion is a time of remembrance, a self-examination, and honesty in the body. And those who take it seriously continue to be steadfast in the Lord. Taking part in the Lord's Supper is not an empty or meaningless ritual. It is a vital reminder of what Jesus has done for us, and it is a vital building block in creating a strong church and strong believers. Amen? Some others would say that the communion is just meaningless for them. But then, you should be aware of this. You should be aware. Before partaking with the breaking of bread, you should first examine yourself. Because in 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 29 to 30, 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verses 29 to 30, for he that eateth and drinketh unworthily, eateth and drinketh damnation to himself, not discerning the Lord's body. Next, in verse 30, for this cause many are weak and sickly among you, and many sleep. I remind you, Christians, if you wish to partake in the breaking of bread or in the communion, you should first examine yourself worthily. Be honest with yourself. Be honest with yourself. Because if you are not worthy, there will be a problem for you. That's what the Bible says. For many are weak and sickly among you, and many sleep. So, devotion was prevalent or widespread among the church. Devotion of fellowship. Next, the devotion in breaking bread. This is the communion. The next one, let us see. The devotion in prayer. The devotion in prayer. I think all of us knows about this item. Those who love the Lord talk to Him on a regular basis.
Amen.
A regular basis. Those who love the Lord talk to Him on a regular basis. Not only during Friday or during Sunday in visitor service or in Bible study, but then as a true disciple of the Lord Jesus Christ, you should talk to Him, to our Lord God, on a regular basis. I understand some of you are so busy with your work, and probably when you arrive in your room, You're very haggard, you're very tired, and even by just sitting down in your bed, you fall asleep, and you forgot to pray. According to James Montgomery, is also a poet and a hymnal writer. Prayer is the Christian's vital breath, the Christian's native air. It is impossible to live a healthy Christian life apart from a meaningful prayer life. I would like to ask you, brothers and sisters, do you have a meaningful prayer life being a Christian now? If not, there's a problem with you, I think. It's a problem with you. We should talk to the Lord on a regular basis. Regular basis. You know what? A Christian life is a life full of prayers. It's a life full of prayers. Aski saan ka? Before you drive, you pray. Before you go out, before you depart your house, you pray. Before you preach, you pray. Before you go to the church, you pray. Before you eat, you pray. Our Christian life should be a life full of prayers. And we should need to talk to our Lord God on a regular basis. Same like the early church. The early church eagerly participated in prayer. And same with us here in BBC. We do have the prayer, corporate prayer before the service, before the Vesper service. Because I know and I understand that the church who prays together, this stays together. A church that prays together, stays together. So it's very, very important for us to talk to our Lord God on a regular basis. In Romans chapter 12, verse 12, rejoicing in hope, patient in tribulation, continuing instant in prayer. We as brothers and sisters should pray to each other. Should pray with our needs, our petitions in our life. Especially if you have a brother or sister who is in need, who is ill, who has a problem with their lives, you should pray for them. Because we are one. We are in one accord. Amen? So devotion must be balanced. First, the devotion in fellowship. The devotion in breaking bread, that is communion, and see the devotion in prayer. Roman numeral 3. Dedication was persistent, that is in verses 45 to 46. Meaning to say, dedication was continue firmly, persistent, to continue firmly. In verses 45 to 46, Acts chapter 2, and sold their possessions and goods and parted them to all men as every man had need. In verse 46, and they, continuing daily with one accord in the temple and breaking bread from house to house, did eat their meat with gladness and singleness of heart. First, the dedication through reverence. The dedication through reverence. In Psalm chapter 33, verse 8, I'll read this for you. In Psalm chapter 33, verse 8, I read, Let all the earth fear the Lord. Let all the inhabitants of the world stand in awe of Him. Again, let all the earth fear the Lord. Let all the inhabitants of the world stand in awe of Him. The word awe indicates a holy terror. You have fear, but mingled with respect and affection. Fear of the Lord, but mingled with respect and reverence or affection to the Lord. Dedication through reverence. Granted the purpose for the miracles performed by the apostles. Granted the purpose for this, for the miracles. In Hebrews chapter 2, verses 3 to 4, how shall we escape if we neglect so great salvation, which at the first began to be spoken by the Lord, and was confirmed unto us by them that heard Him? God also bearing them witness, both with signs and wonders, and with diverse miracles and gifts of the Holy Ghost, according to His own will. In Proverbs chapter 10, verse 27, Proverbs chapter 10, verse 27, the fear of the Lord prolongeth days, but the years of the wicked shall be shortened. Amen?
Amen.
The fear of the Lord prolongeth days, but the years of the wicked shall be shortened. So it means, if you have the fear of the Lord, it will prolong your days. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. In Proverbs chapter 14, verse 26, in the fear of the Lord is strong confidence, and His children shall have a place of refuge. As a true disciple, we should have a reverence to our Lord God. Fear, but then may kasamang affection. May kasamang papuri sa Panginoon. Mingled with respect and mingled with affection. Dedication through reverence to our Lord God. And let there be dedication in sacrifice. Dedication in sacrifice. Having all things common does not refer to some type of communal existence. If you have read in verse, it is in Book of Acts, having things, in the Book of Acts, right? And all that believe were together and had all things common. Having all things common does not refer to some types of communal existence. It means, take note, that they shared with all the believers from the various regions of the world who had gathered at Jerusalem. So it is very clear from verse 46 that some of the believers still have homes. So if you check on this verse, in verse 46, and all that believed were together and had all things common, and sold their possessions and goods, and parted them to all men, as every man had need. Ami Carmichael said he hailed from Ireland and went to India to be a missionary. She says, you can give without loving, but you cannot love without giving. Amen? You can give without loving, but you cannot love without giving. This should be emphasized to all Christians. that we should continue on loving other people, especially with the family of believers. Amen? The emphasis in this passage is that as needs arose, they were willing to sell what they had in order to meet the needs of the other believers. They were willing to sell what they had in order to meet the needs of the other believers. What is the result then of continuing faithfully together as the followers of Jesus Christ? What is the result? There was gladness and singleness of heart, marked by sincerity and a lack of selfishness. There was praise to God, the early church exalted the Lord, and there was growth. The Lord continuously added to the church, such as should be saved. If we are to continue as a true disciple, if we are going to continue as a true disciple of our Lord Jesus Christ, we must be bound by God's doctrine, number one, encouraged in God's love, and dedicated to God's service. Amen?
Amen.
And thank you for hearing the word of God, and God bless you all.
Amen.